Hey guys, what is going on? This is a re-upload because I managed to upload an entire video without any sound, so good job me. I wanted to talk about this article that I found from Creative Law Center. You can find this article in the comments or in the description of the video. So it's basically talking about CC0 and what that means and how we can use it commercially. So museums hold the art treasures of the world in their collections. Many of these treasures are in the public domain, but despite the fact that these works should be freely accessible to and usable by the public, museums have often prevented that from happening by limiting access to high-resolution images. Licensing quality images of public domain work has been a business model in the art world since the invention of the camera. That model is beginning to change as innovative museums and galleries offer access images openly. It used to be that if you wanted to write a book about Vincent van Gogh, for example, whose works have been in the public domain since at least 1960, you could describe his work, but you couldn't reproduce it without licensing the images from the institutions in possession of it. But that is changing. So, Creative Commons Zero, CC0. Creative Commons Zero is a public domain dedication tool that, when applied to a work or creative content, permanently relinquishes all copyright and related rights that an owner may have in a work. CC0 works may be used free of charge for both commercial and non-commercial purposes without prior consent or permission, including copying, modification, distribution, or performance. The language from the license reads, "The public can reliably and without fear of claims of infringement build upon, modify, incorporate in other works, reuse and redistribute," that's an important word, "as freely as possible in any form whatsoever, and for any purposes, including without limitation, commercial purposes." So what does that actually mean for us? In the United States, reproduction photographs of paintings and two-dimensional art are not protected by copyright. If the art is in the public domain, then a photograph of the art can be freely used, including for commercial. And then this is an important case. The case is Bridgman Art versus Coral Corporation. Bridgman is a United States-based company that acquires photographs of public domain works of art and then license use of high-quality reproductions. Bridgman's business model was based on providing potential customers with CD-ROM of low-resolution images as a catalogue to entice them to license use of high-resolution images. So, what's happening now? This is US museums embrace CC0 and open access images. This is a list of museums and galleries in the United States that have adopted the open access business model. These are links to their searchable collections, their open access policies, and a few notes about how to use the sites. So I used this as an example last time. If I open this here, you can see that this is a really, really cool website with lots of images of birds, it seems, and just general science. So I'm just gonna click a random one, Australian Botanical. I'm gonna open this one here. And then all of these images, which will eventually load, are free public domain use. And all you need to do is attribute in the Redbubble description. Okay, so because I'm not 100% sure how this works, I'm not a lawyer, I'm just reading from this website. What I assume we have to do is we have to edit the photo a little bit to make it acceptable. But I don't even know if we have to do that. But just in case, I'm gonna show you how to do it. So I've got this image here from the website. I already did this, as you can see. I'm going to make it a bit bigger, I'm going to edit it, and I'm going to remove the background. So first of all, I've removed the background. It doesn't remove it perfectly, but because this is just an example, I'm just showing you what we can do very easily with Canva Pro in order to make a unique design. And then I'm going to press edit again, and I'm going to click see all, and where it says saturation, I'm going to put it all the way down, so now it's a black and white design, and now that's a sticker, which I could sell on Redbubble, and I could very easily find keywords for it. At the end, you just need to press download, transparent background, and then download. You can also use a free tool like GIMP or something like Photopia to do the same thing. I just have Canva Pro because I like it and I'm lazy, basically. So I found this out recently, and again, I'll leave this in the comments, but I do want to quickly talk about the part under here. But this is very, very cool, and something like this, this is such a beautiful image, and we can very easily sell this on Redbubble. But I want to talk about UK museums embrace the contract ties that bind. The outcome of Bridgman, which was the case I talked about before, upset those in control of British museums. Perhaps they disliked having an upstart American court giving an opinion on British copyright law. The British Museum's copyright group hired a renowned copyright barrister who decried the Bridgman opinion in an attempt to bolster the licensing business model of UK museums. This is an important part of this article. The British Museum continues to claim copyright ownership in the images of its collection. It uses a Creative Commons license designation that does not permit the commercial use of its images. So if I'm reading this correctly and if I understand this correctly, basically this list of websites here we can use, but we cannot use the British Museum, for example, which is a shame because the British Museum is full of beautiful history that would make incredible designs on Redbubble, but unfortunately it's not available. The last thing I want to show you guys is I want to open, let's just open this one just randomly, so Smithsonian. The cool thing about these websites, there are two cool things. Number one is we could look at them on Ahrefs, but if you don't want to pay for Ahrefs, we can also look at them on Google. So I can put tools, anytime, and then the past year, for example, and these are all things that have just started ranking on Google in the last year. This seems to be a video, which is not what I want. So I can do in URL minus events to remove events. Okay, what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to do in URL and then exhibitions. And this is something we could look at for some collections, which we could very easily make into a Redbubble collection. That's the general idea behind this, guys. But yeah, definitely check these out for yourself. Apparently they're just completely free to use, which is really, really cool. And all you would probably have to do is give an attribution of the original artist and also the website that you got it from on your Redbubble description. Now, I do want to say, if anyone knows anything different and has any different information and can tell me why this would not be allowed, then please leave a comment and explain, and maybe we can have a conversation. Because as I said, I'm not a lawyer, but from my understanding of reading this article, from what seems to be a good website, it seems like we can use these images. Thanks for watching, guys, and the original article will be in the comments, and as usual, peace out.